as I said, fortunately, every file read is not going to result in going through so many hoops to get the data blocks. This is where caches come into play. So when you start with a file name and an offset on a client node, you look up the directory, and from that, you get an index and an offset. So this is a data structure which is in the client memory. And once you get the index and the offset, and if this file has been accessed before, it is most likely in your own Unix cache. This is a file cache of the file system. And if it is in your cache, then you get the data block. In other words, going from the file name to the data block that is associated with the file is all happening through the client memory because of local caching. And this is the fastest path for file access, and hopefully this is the common case. Now it is possible that a file is shared, or the same file is being read by different clients at different points of time. But in either case, there is a possibility that a particular file has been accessed by a client and therefore in the cache of that client. And so the next possibility is that you start with the directory, you don't find it in your local cache. And if you don't find it in your local cache, then you have to go to the manager node in order to get a copy of the file. So this is where the manager map data structure, which is a replicated data structure, is available in the memory of every client. And so given the index number and the offset, I can go and look up the manager map data structure. And that tells me who's the manager that I have to contact to get this particular file. So this might involve a network hop, because if the manager node is different from the local node, then I have to go to the manager node across the network. And when I get to the manager node may say, oh, you know what? This particular file has been accessed by a different client. I know that because my metadata says that some of the client has got this in their cache. So the manager will tell the client that currently is holding a copy of the file in its cache to please send the data over to the first guy that requested it. Now the data that I requested is coming not from my local cache, but it is coming from the cache of a peer. And that's much better than going to the disk and pulling it out of the disk, because network speeds are much faster than accessing the disk. So this is the second best path for file access. Sure, there is network communication involved here, because the first thing that I have to do is I have to hop over the network to get to the manager node if, in fact, I'm not the manager node myself for this particular file that I'm looking for. There is a network hop. And there could be another network hop if the manager says, oh, this particular file is cached in a different node. In that case, there is another network hop to go over to the client that currently containing that particular file. And once we get to that, there may be another network hop in order to send the data over to the first requester. So potentially there could be three network hops in order to get the file that I'm looking for, but it could be less than that, depending on the co-location of the manager and the node that is requesting it, or the manager and the node that contains a copy of that file itself. So this is the second best path for file access. But there is also the pathologically real long way of accessing a particular file. And that path is shown here using all of the data structures that I mentioned earlier that is available at the manager. You start with the file name, look up the directory, get the index number and the offset. It's not in your cache. You go to the manager by looking up the manager map data structure that's in my local memory. I go to the manager, and the manager then looks up its metadata for this file, finds that nobody has it in their cache, so it has to pull it from the disk. If it has to pull it from the disk, then it has to look up its IMAP data structure, the IMAP data structure, and the Stripe Group Map data structure in order to find out the location of the inode that corresponds to the log segment that I'm looking for. That lookup happens through this IMAP data structure, Stripe Group Map data structure. Then I can go to the storage server and get the index node of the log segment ID for the requested data block of this client. Once I have that, then the manager has to look up the Stripe Group Map to say what storage servers have this log segment striped, and out of that, which storage server should I contact for the particular portion of the file that you're looking for? And that storage server will be contacted, and that storage server is going to give the data block that is requested by the client. So you can see that in this long path, there is network hop as well as accessing the storage servers to pull the data blocks. It is possible that the index node for the log segment ID associated with this file has been previously accessed by this manager, in which case it doesn't have to go to the storage server to get the index node for the log segment because it will be present in the memory of the manager as part of its caching strategy. And therefore, it can bypass these two network hops because directly from this stripe group map, it can figure out what the log segment ID is locally cached so that it can then go to this stripe group map data structure and figure out where on the disk the data blocks for that log segment is actually stored. So we might be able to get rid of at least two of these network hops if we are lucky and this particular log segment has been accessed before by this manager. It'll be in the memory of the manager, and therefore we can avoid these two network hops. But the worst case scenario, if this particular log segment has never been accessed before, then the long way to get to the data block that you're requesting is going through the data structures in the manager, network hop, storage lookup, and get the data and give it to the client.